Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for June the 18th of 2020, well, it is titled The Tadpoles of IC-410. So, what do we see here? Well, this is a star-forming region, and when we see star-forming regions, there are certain things that we tend to see. This is a relatively young region, only a few million years old, but we see all the telltale signs of star formation, including dark clouds, darker dense areas, where the star formation is just beginning. We see some brighter clouds, which are illuminated by stars that have already formed, forming an emission nebula, where the atoms in the gases are energized by the ultraviolet radiation from the hot stars. It excites the electrons in those atoms and causes them to glow and give off specific colors. We also see here what are called the tadpoles. Off to the right-hand side, the lower right, we see two objects that look somewhat like tadpoles. Those contain denser knots towards the upper side, the upper left side, and then material trailing back behind them. These are some of the denser knots of star formation, where stars are forming at this point. And the material behind them is slightly protected by that knot of material. Now, what forms these is the material left over and the intense stellar winds and radiation pressure from the hot stars in the cluster at the center of the image. So the very young cluster with very hot stars produce a lot of energy and push out much of the gas and dust that we see. What tends to survive are the denser clumps of material, and that's when we get things like the tadpoles that we see off here to the lower right. Those occur when the denser material being left behind is the hardest part for these stars to eat away at. The less dense material gets pushed out, and eventually, over millions of more of years, this will get cleaned out and we will have just a cluster of stars left behind. So while star formation is still going on and will continue, it also becomes a fight between the stars and the dust. And eventually the stars are going to win. The stars that have formed will push out the material, and eventually there will be not enough dust for any further star formation. So the dust and gas will get pushed away, and we'll have far less material for star formation. So what we see here is the image that you get of all the different details when we look at a star-forming region. Now, this was taken with what we call narrow-band filters, meaning we're looking at very specific wavelengths of emission of light. So even though this was taken in a suburban sky, it was able, by focusing on just very specific wavelengths of light, it's able to avoid a lot of the light pollution that you might otherwise get. It's just very focused and looking at only specific emission from specific atoms within these nebulae. So that was our picture of the day for June the 18th of 2020. It was titled, The Tadpoles of IC-410. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.